So, in Pokemon Sword and Shield, there will be no direct communication with Pokemon Go. What is up, guys? I'm Daddy Gamer Fred, and today we're going to be talking about this Eurogamer Masuda interview. And in the interview, he gets asked about Pokemon Go and its integration in Sword and Shield. Would it be like it was with Pokemon Let's Go? They dropped the bombshell. Well, not really the bombshell, because the writing's on the wall if you've been following the news stories as far as Pokemon Home. And, you know, us not having the complete Pokedex and all this, we kind of knew that, you know, there was going to be other ways to connect to the game, but Pokemon Go probably wasn't going to be one of them. It says, in Pokemon Sword and Shield, there's no direct communication with Pokemon Go. But if you have seen the announcement for Pokemon Home, you have a Pokemon in Pokemon Go that you want to have in Pokemon Sword and Shield, you have to wait until Pokemon Home drops, drop that Pokemon in Home, and then connect Home to Sword and Shield and bring that Pokemon over, only if that Pokemon is inside of the Galar Pokedex. To me, it doesn't sound too crazy. I've seen a lot of this brought up today of Pokemon Go fans being, you know, crying and whining about it. Listen, I've been playing Pokemon Go since it came out. I enjoy the game. Not a huge fan of it lately, and I could go into that in a separate video. But to me, this isn't a big deal. In Pokemon Let's Go, I used Pokemon Go integration as a dumping ground for Kanto Pokemon. What I mean is that when I caught a Kanto Pokemon in Go, I didn't just discard it right away like I do every other Pokemon. What I did is kept the Pokemon for me to drop into Let's Go. That way I could get double candy. I could get a candy inside of Pokemon Go and then get another candy inside of Pokemon Let's Go, so I could use those candies inside of Pokemon Go that I got in Go, and then also use the candies that I got in Pokemon Let's Go for basically doubling up on the trade. To me, I thought that was more efficient way, and to the point that I got like literally like 10 PokeGo parks inside of Let's Go filled up with Pokemon that I just need to go in and catch. And because of the catch mechanic inside of Let's Go, it's fucking annoying. But I'll probably say that for like a live stream or a video where I just jump in and just catch every fucking Pokemon that I've been dumping in. However, it's not a big deal. We could still bring over your, you know, fucking shiny Mewtwo that you catch inside of Pokemon Go that you want to bring into Pokemon Sword and Shield, granted if that Pokemon is allowed in. So I don't see what the big deal is. Maybe I'm missing something. Maybe the fact that people are complaining is because Pokemon Home doesn't come out until next year, so we don't know how long of a wait that's gonna be. With the way Pokemon Company has been pumping out these fucking mobile games, I doubt it's gonna be past February. I think we're gonna see Pokemon Home come up and they're gonna just be like, hey, you know, February's here. Here is Pokemon Home. Here is what it can do around the same time we get that fucking like meeting they do every year. I think we're gonna get that Pokemon Home drop on us and probably announce what games are gonna be coming out that year as well. To me, I feel like this shouldn't be a big of an issue as it is, and I don't get why people are so hung up on it. Again, I think it's because they are uncertain about the release date of Home, and they want their Pokemon that are in Go in Sword and Shield. And I'm like, I could wait. You know what I'm saying? It's not like we got the National Dex inside of Sword and Shield anyway, so it's not like you're going to be missing a Pokemon that you caught in Go that you don't have in any other game that you want to just bring in just to complete the Dex. To me, it's a non-issue. But let me know. But this is a discussion. Let me know how you feel about it in the comment section below. As you guys know, I answer all comments. I'm going to see you guys down there. Let's talk about this. Let's talk about if Pokemon Sword and Shield not having communication with Pokemon Go is a game changer for you. Is it going to make or break the way that you were going to play Pokemon Sword and Shield? Let's talk about it in the comments. If you're new around here, hit that subscribe button. I do videos like this every day. If you want to be notified on the next time I drop a video, ring the bell, hit that like button. It does help me out a ton as far as moving the video over to recommended. I love you guys. I'm going to see you guys on the next one. Like always, guys, I'm Daddy Gamer Fred on Instagram and Twitter, and you guys can bring the conversation there. I'm the American Gamer in Switzerland right here on YouTube, and yes, I'm going to be doing a ton of videos just like this one. So if you enjoy, please hit that subscribe button. Also, hit the like button. It does help me out a ton as far as growing the channel is concerned. Ring the bell if you want to be notified on the next time I drop a video. Peace. I'm going to see you guys on the next one.